tickets for the American Car Care Center's $30,000 Candlepin Challenge, brought to you by the International Candlepin Bowling Association. Hello, folks. Hello, folks. I'm Philip Burton alongside Dan Murphy. Dan, can anyone stop Kevin Davis?
I don't know, but they got to get through this challenges match first, and that brings us right into the format. The format is a single game, and the winner of the face our champion, Kevin Davis. And will one of these bowlers stop him? I don't know. But it's going to take a monumental effort, that's for sure. And the points are very, very important. We got a little sidelight to the points because our top point getter, Rico, is here. He did it against Kevin. I mean, there's a lot of scenarios going on here. But we give them points for spares, for strikes, for combinations of spares and strikes. And, of course, always 750 points for winning that championship match.
All right, thanks a lot, Dan. Now let's go over to Trina Fernandez, who's standing by with a couple of show favorites. Trina.
That's right, Phil. We've got Rico Baldinelli and Chris Sargent in the house, and they're old friends to the show. Everybody knows these guys. Rico, now you, as Dan just mentioned, have the pressure on you of being the highest point getter so far. But a little interesting aside, this should be one of the closest challenger matches we've ever seen because these guys tied in the roll-off to get here. So tell us, what's your strategy today, Rico?
Well, we tied in the roll-off. Today's different. Thing is there's only one string, so you just have to come right out after him. And there's, you know, can't wait too late. Just hope you get off to a good start, and hopefully that will carry you through.
You feeling the pressure?
I'm feeling a little bit of pressure, yeah. But once we get going, it'll be all right.
All right. Well, good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, and Chris, we know you well as we can. You're one of our favorites. Now, you know this guy pretty well. Tell us what happened in the roll-off.
Yeah, well, I called up to see how it was, and they said that we ended up tying, so, which was good. You know, like Rico said, it's one string, new day, see what happens. We'll take it there, you know.
And then it's Kevin Davis if you get past Rico.
Yeah, Kevin's on a roll. He's pulling real good. So you got to get by one first, so we'll see what we can do.
All right. Well, good luck to both of you. Back to Phil.
All right, thanks a lot, Trina. Standing by with us right now is our champ, Kevin Davis. He's been on an incredible roll. And, Kevin, you're familiar with both these bowlers.
Yeah, unfortunately, I'm very familiar with Rico this year. But actually, the three of us bowled on a Worlds team together about, like 8 or 10 years ago.
Now, the last time you and Rico met, he defeated you. So you left with a little revenge today, or what?
Yeah, he put the whooping on me. He ended up going like 3-something, I remember that. And then he threw the big score point. So, yeah, whichever one. Got to bowl one of them.
All right, well, good luck today, Kevin.
Okay, thanks.
All right, Rico Baldinelli on top of our point leaders with 2,300. Kevin Davis in second with 2250, and Mike Morgan in third with 2,000. Folks, we'll be back with the start of the American Car Care Center's $30,000 Candlepin Challenge right after these messages. Welcome back to Rollaway Lanes, folks, and we're in Massachusetts for the American Car Care Center's $30,000 Candlepin Challenge. And starting us off, Rico Baldinelli. Like we said at the top of the show, Rico's on top. He's one of he's our first and foremost point leader with 2,300. He knows how to string them together, as we say here.
He certainly does.
All right. Rico just dropping 5 there. There it is. There's the spare up on the first. Baldinelli wasting no time. Seeing there on the replay. And he can't afford to waste any time because he has a fierce competitor in Chris Sargent.
That's right.
This should be a good show. This should really be a good show. Baldinelli with the 1, 3, and 7.
I couldn't really hear Trina at the beginning of the show, but I don't know if she mentioned that the tie, these bowlers in the final roll-off to appear on the show, they ended up in a tie, 671 apiece. So they had to go to the tiebreaker, which was the high single. Chris had 157 and Rico 152. Therefore, Rico leads off. Chris is more or less the top seed.
Right. Rico Baldinelli now with 25 after 2, and here's our first look at Chris Sargent today. He leads the four horsemen to the right, plus the 8. Dan, you know, we were saying last week, we don't like to look at your competitor. I think Rico takes the same approach.
Yeah, he does.
Sitting there with his head down. Doesn't like to look up much. pin box for Chris Sargent. You see him there. Like I said, Danny, he doesn't like to look at his competition, but he'll see what they're doing. Chris Sargent averaging 134. Tirico's average of 126.
It looks bad, 8-10, but with the wood there, looks like he's got a lot of room. Flip that wood, the ball takes the 10, the wood takes the other 10.
It does, he called it. All right, Sargent answering with a spare of his own in a second.
Didn't have as much room as I thought. It hit it from behind, right there. Almost twirled in back of it and missed it altogether. Good shot by Chris, though.
Piece of wood is way out front. Yeah. So Earl's going down to check it out. You know, we were saying earlier that Kevin Davis is familiar with both these bowlers. I wondered who he'd rather bowl against.
I don't think he'd tip his hat.
Yeah, I don't think so either.
Well, he did mention he got a whooping from this gentleman.
So maybe he wants a little revenge.
Yeah, maybe. 33 after three for Rico.
But first, Baldinelli has to get past Chris Sargent, which is no easy task.
One, five, eight. Straight eagle plus the nine. Not a way to try to make a spare. Effort. Look at this.
Oh,
everything but the three. Great try by Rico.
That's money.
There you go. Look at
another look.
Puts the two and the four. Two pin goes over in between. And here comes something. I don't know what pin that was. It knocked down the nine and the ten, leaving just the three.
All right, here's Sargent. Got the 4-6. Waiting for that wood as it goes back and forth.
Well, you got two in the channel to the left. And he hits that hard, it's going to come out. Whether it come all the way across, I don't know. Now they got a couple pieces out, but.
All right, 38 rather, after three for Chris Sargent.
5-pin advantage.
Spread eagle once again, plus the eight.
Similar shot that Rico had, opposite side with that pin in the back. He had the nine. Chris has got the eight pin in the back.
I'm clearing out the right side, but leaves the left.
Keep the 5-pin lead. Needs these 4 pins.
No, only gets three of them. So
3 pins.
Chris Sargent up by three. Very close. Good ball, Baldinelli. He's got the 5-10.
Okay, Rico, Rico Baldinelli's bowling for Albert Cayer, C-A-Y-E-R, from Springfield, Massachusetts. So, Al, you probably know the drill. Rico can knock off Chris Sargent and then knock off our defending champ. We'll send you a check for $25.
That's $9 for Mr. Baldinelli. He's at 52 after five.
Not an easy spare. The wood should help on the nine, but we get the 10. Yes, enough. Spare in the fifth.
He was looking for that one. His second spare of the day. Take another look. He does get the nine.
Yeah, just Wood just tips that.
Falling late, but he doesn't get it nonetheless. Another spread eagle from Sargent.
Chris Sargent will be bowling, or is bowling, for Rita Young from Attleboro, Massachusetts. So Rita, you're rooting for him. If he can go all the way and become the champ today, we'll send you a check for 25. Still a three-pin advantage, but now he faces the mark put up by Rico in the sixth.
Wow.
Spread out. He just can't get them together.
Unbelievable.
It's been all over the head pin, but either full or he scatters them like this, but leaves it.
Well, he's got
two.
The 4, 7,
yeah.
8, and 10.
No, 9 and 10, I think.
9 and 10. Yeah. Now just the 9 and 10. Box. Sargent.
The lead is just two pins for Chris, but that could be erased right now. Rico could,
yeah, on this fill right here,
retake the lead. Had the lead after one box, and Chris took it back. Yeah, that's going to take it back. It's nine.
Yeah, that's a nice drop right there, leaving just the five.
Seven pin advantage late, halfway through.
That's good.
Two in a row.
Back-to-back spares for Baldinelli.
Here's the important one, eighth frame.
Yeah, you always say always, the eighth.
Yeah,
frame.
Always
important.
It really is. Sets up that final two, and here he has a lead of seven. If he drops a decent fill and gets another mark, it really puts a lot of pressure on Chris.
Well, he only gets six on the fill, so.
Yeah, and he doesn't leave himself a legitimate spare lead. He's going to try the wood to the left. He'd like to see a little more of that seven pin if he could. The wood has a chance of getting the 5 and maybe the 6-10, but the 7 pin could be a problem.
Yeah. Oh, the ball almost came back and grabbed the 7, but it didn't happen. Yeah,
that's why he wanted to see a little more of the 7 pin so the ball would take the 7.
All right, that's 9 for Baldinelli. 96 after 8. Nice drop, but a nasty split in. I mean,
you just can't
four,
get two together.
I know. He's right on the head, though.
Ike, is that good? That was 9 box.
9 box, yeah. I think that was out.
Turned away, didn't see that. Didn't hit the gutter. Didn't turn in the channel of the gutter. Again, nothing to shoot at. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Been on the head pin the whole match, but nothing to shoot at. Not even a piece of wood on the deck.
4, 5, 7. Well, he's going to score after that 4. And that's all he grabs.
You know, it almost looks like sometimes he throws the ball too hard and everything takes off up over the top.
Right. All right, Sargent at 82 after 8.
He's got to hope that Rico doesn't put another mark up. He's still 2 marks away from him. Chance for the 9th and 10th unless Rico puts a mark up. And he's in a double strike.
And that's
a big one.
That's huge. That is huge right there. Baldinelli. And making it happen when it counts.
Some guy buries it in the head pin. He's going to miss the head pin. He leaves the 1 and the 3 for a spare lead. You got to give him credit.
Yeah.
He cashes in on the break.
Sure does. Six on. So Rico finishing up with a 132.
Well, the only chance is strikes.
Yeah.
We have throw a few strikes. He can do that, but see, that's the first time he missed a head pin. That's the best spare leave he's had all day.
Yeah,
that's not good.
I know. That isn't good.
It's amazing that Chris Sargent in his town, he just can't get, has a tough time getting by this challenger's match. A lot of times you think he'd get by this, he could start a streak of his own because he's got a lot of talent. But
right.
This is what makes it interesting, this one game. And on any given day, anyone can beat anyone. Not to take anything away from Rico, because Rico's a fine bowler.
Indeed.
But he just, he's finally smiling about it, but nothing to shoot at all day.
Yeah, sometimes you have those days, Dan, yeah. You know? Nothing you can do. You put forth your best effort, but it's just not falling your way. And it has been one of those days for Chris Sargent. As Rico Baldinelli will advance 132 to 101. Rico taking it by 31. We'll be back with more right after these messages. Davis throwing up a strike in the first. Unbelievable. I know Dan would have loved to have seen that one. Nailing the strike, the five going late, unbelievable. He's got the 4-7 rocking down there, but they're going to remain up. The 4-7 and 10. Dan is actually at a concert. Have you ever heard of Yanni?
Yeah, I listened to it with him on the way down.
Did you really? Well, he's going to a concert with his lovely wife, Cheryl. So, I hope they have a wonderful time.
They should. They leave me down here 2.5 hours from home, so.
They just left you behind, huh?
It's Kevin with the 9 box. 19 after the first one, 28 after two. Put 100 points on the board.
And here is Rico Baldinelli. Started off pretty fast himself in the challenges match. He's looking to start off pretty quick. Or to answer Kevin Davis with a mark in the first. Not going to be easy.
Good try. By the way, our contestant in the audience today is Kelly Presker from Ware, Mass. She's the she's rooting for Kevin. That's our contestant in the audience today. Cook 9 box.
Yeah.
I suppose both these guys are rooting for one another, huh, Phil?
Yeah, absolutely. They're cheering each other on. They can't lose.
Right.
They can't lose.
All
right, here's Rico leading the 5 and the 10. Well, I guess they're playing for cold cash right now.
That's right, yeah. One more, two more weeks left.
That's it. Season goes by so fast. It's unbelievable, folks.
Took 9 box, 18 after 2 for Rico.
All right, and Kevin Davis, our champ, up by 10. Kevin now. Working on his 7th straight victory.
I'm sure he's trying to win this time for going back home the next time. Tate.
Yeah.
In our neck of the woods.
That's right. Oh, nice shot by Kev. Leaving just the 4 and the 7. He's got that piece of wood rolling over towards the 4. That kind of blocks his path now.
He's going to come up high on him, play almost on the cap, I would think.
Davis knew it all along. Earl calling it.
Learn from the best of the best,
yes,
Dan.
Yes, indeed. No doubt about it. All right, Davis, 38 after 3, plus is still coming up. All right, gets 5 on that. So it's the spread eagle minus the 7. Now Davis wasting no time. Put a mark up in the first and the third because he knows Rico is a fierce competitor. That 4-pin is not going to go for him, but still a 9 box nonetheless for Kevin Davis, and he is at 52 after 4.
He's got a quick 150 points there. You show both these guys rooting, though.
Yeah.
As long as they go on, nobody else has a chance. So.
Absolutely. Here's Baldinelli dropping 8. got the 410. Plenty of wood in front.
He's looking it over. It's a tough shot either way.
Yeah, it is. Well, he uses the wood to take out the 10, but he misses the 4, so he'll look to get that on this ball here.
Another 10 box. 28 out the 3 for Rico.
See there, Davis with a 15-pin advantage. But Baldinelli can close that in no time. Yeah. Especially with strikes like that.
You called it, Phil.
Unbelievable. Okay.
That was quick.
Baldinelli marking up in the fourth with a big strike. Check it out on the replay, right on that head pin, driving them all down. But you know, Davis can answer. He's got the four horsemen. 1-2-4-7. You see his high single there of 201. Oh,
just missed that one.
Yeah, eliminated the 2 and the 4. Nice 10. Nice out. Excellent out. Taking out the 1 and a 7. All right, Davis at 62 after 5.
He doesn't waste any time, does he?
No, he certainly doesn't. Only drops 4 on that one, though. He's got the 4 horsemen to the right, plus the 7 and 9, so blowing on the hand, making some magic happen.
He has over the weeks.
Certainly has. Not much there, though. He's attempting to get away with 9. Now it'll just be 8 for Baldinelli. Or for Kevin Davis, rather. He's at 70 after 6. And here's Rico stepping up in lane 11, looking for an excellent fill on his strike.
Yeah, first mark of the day. He wants a 7 to go.
It does go. Called it, off. Went late for him, but it went nonetheless. He's got like somewhat of a roadblock down there.
It's going to be, right on the left line, red line on the left hand. Just drive it straight back.
Missed it. Yeah, that wood did not help him that time.
No, a lot of people take those for granted.
Yeah.
I think if you asked Rico, he probably would have played it a little differently. Yeah. Either way.
Kind of played it the same way.
Yeah.
All right, that's 9 for Baldinelli. Oh, putting himself in a very makeable spear here. Leaving just the 4 and 7. There's another piece of wood in front of it, though.
He wants it to roll back out of the way, so you need a clear shot at it.
I don't think it's going to go far enough.
There he goes.
4. Oh, it is clearing out 4. Patience pays off. But if you wait too long, it might roll back.
Hey, he doesn't want that, so hurry up and there it goes.
There
all
it
over.
A clear shot. 66 after 6. All right, folks, we have to take a break, but we'll be back with Rico Still to see if he can catch Kevin Davis. We'll be back in just a moment.
Remember fun? You know, lots of laughter, jumping up and down. If you want to experience fun again, you'll find it at your local Candlepin Bowling Center. That's where you'll find plenty of parties and good times.
Visit Boutwell's Bowling Center in Concord for your next birthday party, corporate party, or for great family fun. Visit our website for more information.
It's Candlepin, and it's better than ever.
Let's go! Good times roll.
All right, welcome back, folks. There you see our champ, Kevin Davis, only up by 4, minus Rico Baldinelli still in the 6th. He threw up a spare in the 6th, and he's up 70 to 66. But Kevin Davis will be looking for a mark of his own right here in the 7th. Almost gets it, everything but the 5. Got two pieces of wood down there to the left of the 5. Actually, one's they're rolling out.
go right after the kingpin.
All right, it's just him and the king. Who's it going to be? I guess it's the king this time.
The king wins again.
Not that time, though, so it's a good 10 box for Kevin Davis. He is at 80 after 7.
Slow down a little. Yeah. 2 weeks. Still out in front, though. I don't think he has been behind.
No, he hasn't. Past 4 or 5 weeks, he has not been behind. That's huge. Needed that one. Putting up a strike in the eighth. As Dan always says, the eighth box is the clutch box.
There's a key on the way out, yes.
See it there, folks. On the pin cam, up close and personal.
Chips out to 4 and 6. The last one's to fall.
Baldinelli trying to answer. He's got the 4, 5, and 7. Yeah, he's got some wood out in front of the 4 and 5. It's pretty far out, though.
It's pretty far out. If I say anything, he's going to play the... it's tilted that way, so he's going to play it down right-hand side.
Called it, but he just took away the 7 with that. So now he's getting up to the 4 and 5. Clear shot at either one. All right, sides on the 5. 9 box for Rico. And he is with a 2-pin advantage as of right now, but Kevin Davis still has a fill on his strike, so.
Boy, he splits all the time here.
Yeah, these are some tough splits.
Yeah, we saw Chris with it in the first game, and then now Rico.
Oh, nice shot there. Piece of wood came around, taking out the 10. That's a good 10.
Nice 10 for 92 after 8. And here comes the fill for Kevin. Kevin's got 250 points as we stand right now. So I don't think any of the points are in jeopardy unless...
I don't even know if they care about the points. This was about the money. And perhaps for Kevin, a little bit of revenge.
Revenge from the first time.
Door. 6 won't go then, so the 3-6 now.
Yeah, 8 on the strike. Took 10 box there.
All right, Davis at 108 after 9. Davis takes back the lead by 6.
Oh, Rico's hanging around, so.
Certainly is, right on his heels. You know, this has been the first match in a while that somebody's been on Kevin Davis' heels.
Yeah, I would say under 10 pins. He's got a good 20-pin lead after the first game.
Yeah. And the past couple of weeks, he's beaten his opponents by over 20. So.
Yeah, he's been on a roll in this place. These lanes are kind to him.
He likes the feel. That's 8. For Davis, he finishes with a 116.
Kevin doing a little house cleaning there. Well, I hope Dan's going to have fun tonight.
I'm sure he will. I didn't know Dan was into the new age stuff.
I think when you're driving down here so early in the morning, you'll listen to something halfway.
Baldinelli with a half whisker right.
I forgot to mention that while I slid over, I had a friend of mine that works with us at the lanes, Mickey Landrigan over here is keeping score while I slid over his seat. He slid into my seat for a couple of games here. Here's Rico with a 9.
Baldinelli, 101 after 9. This one is far from over, folks.
That's right. You probably want to put up a mark here.
Yeah. Usually this one, though, Kevin Davis has it in the bag.
Bag already, yeah. This is the one right here. You can get a clear shot at the... I think this is a 4-pin.
Yeah, but he's got that wood.
You can't see
it
from my
end. Close. This is going to be kind of close.
Right after it.
That's it. Spare in the 10th?
7 or better here.
That looks pretty good.
There you go.
Leaving just the 1-2. Okay, that's an 8 fill on his spare. Baldinelli comes back to win this one.
Hi, I'm William Walker, and I used to sell satellite dishes. A word of advice if you're thinking about getting one, don't. They were going to charge me $250 for the install, so I figured I'd do it myself. How hard could it be? I used to sell them. To get a signal, I had to put the dish on a pole. Then the wind knocked out the picture. The dish company told me, wait, they'll come back. I got rid of the dish and got Comcast Digital Cable. I don't sell the dish anymore.
She's gonna have to find new bridesmaids.
Well, that about wraps it up. Any questions? You've been awfully quiet, Bob. Bob?
Thirsty for a cold drink? Try a refreshing iced coffee from the coffee experts at Dunkin' Donuts.
Bob?
The secret's out. Brew your favorite iced coffee at home. Get 2 pounds of coffee for only $9.99. Available in-store and at select participating Stop and Shop locations.
Huh? Scary, isn't it? We're making music, but we're also making love.
With Paul Dillon, weekdays 5:30 Eastern on CN8.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Let's get back into some business. I want to talk about the postcards. We want you to send a postcard in, please. So get a paper and pencil and write down this address. Send your postcards to the International Candlepin Bowling Association, $30,000 Candlepin Challenge, 26 South Main Street, Suite 252, Concord, New Hampshire, 03301. Now, two of those postcards will be paired up with our two challengers for the week. And if one of those challengers goes on to unseat our champion, then you will win $25. But there's another way to win. Come on down, have some fun, be a part of the audience, and your name will be entered to a separate drawing. One name will be chosen from the audience and matched with our champ for the week. If the champion goes on to keep his crown, then that lucky audience member will win $25. But now we've got to get back into some bowling. So you know what? I've been waiting to say this all day. Earl, back to you.
Well, thanks, Trina. You know what else to say, Phil? Maybe we'll get
all right,
our
let's take it over to our bowlers then and let them do the speaking for us.
Maybe we can get our
Rico
own.
Rico Baldinelli.
With Phil and Earl, Earl and Phil's fan club down here.
What's that?
We got our own fan club.
No, we don't have it like Trina, though.
Well, Dan's gone now, so we might get in the little action.
Here's Baldinelli in lane 11.
Yes, it's the first, he's got a 3-pin lead.
Yeah, I took the first game, 119 to 116. That's huge. That 10-pin.
There you go.
Oh, he hit them all to go. You know, at first I thought it was just going to be the 10. And the 7 was going to remain, but that's a big strike for Baldinelli in the first. Almost a double. Everything but the 5. So, putting himself in an excellent position.
I think he can.
For spare on strike.
Slide by and nail the 5.
That's going to be close. Yeah. No, not going to happen.
Just a 9 fill on the strike.
An excellent 9 fill on the strike.
I have to mark that one down, though. I think he. 10 box, 29 after 2 for Rico.
Here's our champ, Kevin Davis. You know, in the past, every time his opponent has marked, he has responded with a strike or a spare of his own. So let's see what he gets here. Kind of a rough fall. He's got the 2, 4, 7, and 9. Oh, very close.
Nice try.
So misses out on the 9.
Tipping right, went right behind the 9.
All right, good 10 though for Kev. But I'm sure he's feeling the pressure to mark early just because he hasn't been trailing in a long time. So.
Total lead is up to 12 now.
Yeah. But remember, a few weeks back, he was down by 13 against Mike Morgan, so.
That's right, and he came back in the second game.
Yeah, to win it. down seven there. Eight box for Davis. 18 after two. Baldinelli is extending that lead. He's up to 14 now. Davis. All right, Rico with the four horsemen to the right. 1, 3, 6, 10. Can he make them vanish?
Yeah.
No, almost.
So right in front of the 10 pin.
Eliminating the 1, 3, and 6, but he'll have to get this 10 pin on the next one. He does.
There you go. Solid 10.
All right, Baldinelli, 39 after three. Seven there, he's got the 1, 3, and 7.
Ah.
Not gonna happen.
That's two chances.
Yeah, that three pin almost came back all the way to take the seven. But. All right, 9 for Rico.
48 up to 4 for Rico. I'm sure Kevin here is thinking Mark now.
Yeah, sure he is.
It's, 14 pins.
You know, Baldinelli put the pressure on him right from jump street when he marked up, when he put that strike up in the first. Almost.
There it goes. There it goes. It's going to go.
It does go.
There you go.
Davis throwing his arms up in the air.
Wow. Is that the 5-pin they kicked it out?
That is huge, yes. Let's take another look, Earl.
There it is.
It's the 5. Going right into the 4, unbelievable. Nice fill. 4 pins remain steady. So he's got the 1, 2, 4, and 10.
He's trying to split the 1 and the 1 and the 2. Head pin should be down and take the 10 pin out. A little heavy on it. Yeah. He's got an 8 fill anyway. Chops right into the lead.
Davis now down by 7. This one is not over yet, folks.
Not yet. It's the first time I think he's been in the same position.
Yeah, in quite some time, in weeks, actually. Here's Rico.
Oh,
almost captures that 7, too.
And right in front of the 7. So right over from right to left. 9 bucks.
All right, 9 bucks for Baldinelli. I don't know if you want to leave any open boxes on Kevin Davis. Because he will capitalize.
He's getting down to that crucial point now where all the pins are going to count here, I think.
Certainly do. 1, 2, and 10.
He's got a nice piece of wood out there. He wants to split the 1 and the 2. There you go. Yeah. He isn't getting any good luck.
No, it's not.
No breaks at all for Rico. Well, like you said, Phil, he wants to get all the pins he can.
Yeah, so he'll get after this 10 pin for 10 box. You have a funny feeling. Now it's going to be single digits. Paul Baldinelli, 67 after 6. Kevin Davis looking to capitalize. It's kind of a tough drop there. You know, he has the 5 and the 10. Piece of wood.
There he goes.
Up against that 5, so he can make this happen.
Anywhere from the red line down, I think. Wants to hit right at the 5 pin.
See ya. All right. Trap in the 5th for Davis. Take another Earl. You called it, man. You hit it right down low.
Right where you have to, yeah. That's a big fill.
Using that wood to take out the pin.
Big fill here would set him right up.
Wow, not gonna get it though. Not gonna get it. He only drops 5 on that.
Wow. 5, 7, 8, 9, and 10.
Man, he's got the whole back rope. 5.
Wow.
He's got some wood down there that might aid him a little bit, but this is tough. This is tough. Kevin Davis just examining it.
Yeah, he wants it to stay on the. It's gonna stay on, I believe.
It's gonna stay on.
He wants it to come out a little further, but.
No, it's not gonna help him much though.
No, if it was me, I'd go right after the five pin. Try to split the triangle down there.
Yeah. But,
you know, he could play right off the wall though. That would.
No.
I think if he plays the word of the right, he's just gonna get the 10 pin. I don't think it's gonna come off. Like people think it.
I missed both on that.
Both of them.
An ace off for Davis. All right, folks. Baldinelli. We have to take a break. Baldinelli up by 3. It's coming down to the wire, folks. So please, you have to stay with us.
Remember fun? Being a part of a gang of friends? If you miss being a part of a team, then sign up for League Candlepin Bowling for fun or competition. There's a league for everyone.
Visit Lakeside Lanes and King Bowling Lanes in Manchester and join a league today. Or visit this website for the bowling center near you.
It's Candlepin and it's better than ever.
Let's go! Good times roll.
Five great reasons to choose your American Car Care Center for tires for your car or truck. And here's one more. At your American Car Care Center, the price you see is the price you get. You never pay extra for mounting, balancing, or valve stems. Choose from our trusted brands Michelin, Uniroyal, BF Goodrich, and our own quality American radial.
The right choice, American Car Care Center.
We care about your safety. Visit us today.
All right, welcome back, folks.
There you see it.
Bonus point quote.
Right, Phil. The Davis has 3 strikes and 2 spares, a total of 400 points with 116 after the first game. And Baldinelli has 2 strikes, 2 spares for 300 points with that 119 after the first game.
Unbelievable performance. This one is going back and forth, folks. Right now, Rico Baldinelli is up by 3. The game is this second game is actually tied at 67 apiece. But Baldinelli is up by 3. And it's going down to the last 4 frames. Who's it going to be? Every pin counts. Rico dropping 6 on that one, leaving the triangle plus the 7.
Ah, nice spare right there.
Nice spare.
With the 5 over there. Put that triangle that Danny was talking about.
Yeah, see there.
Put the 8 over into the 7.
Eliminating the 5-7. 8 and 9.
Big fill on this one.
Can't get any bigger than that. That is pretty big, folks. Strike on spare.
That's the place to put it.
That is the place to put it. Right on the head. Take another look, Earl. And taking them all down.
9 pin is the last one to go.
Now, for the first time in weeks, Kevin Davis feeling a little heat. Actually, he's probably feeling a lot of heat. You see him there moving his shirt around there. Maybe breaking into a little
hard
slack.
Another call.
Yeah, nothing wrong with that though. Okay, the 7-4 and 7 fall late for him.
Probably wants to leave that standing there. He's going to try and snap that head pin right over into the
triangle over there.
6 pin, yeah.
9, 10. Almost gets it to go. Wasn't even it? Just the 6 and the 10. I was telling Dan earlier, Rico never likes to look at his opponent. He's looking down again as Kevin puts up a solid 10 box.
It can hurt you if you watch those guys. I know from experience.
More of a psyche thing?
Well, you know, he's right. You watch these people and they don't hit the hit pin, they get a strike or a spare lead. You start burying that ball in the 1-2 to 1-3 pocket, it can wear on you.
Yeah.
I know, he does it to me all the time.
It does it to you all the time.
But yeah, you have to be, it's a mindset.
Yeah.
Like he says, there is no defense in this game. So
right. So you have to remain totally focused.
Stay within your own game. And there's Kevin with a 9 box.
All right. That is a 9 box for Mr. Davis.
Get a ball coming down our way now. Yeah, ball's going all across the lanes right now.
Do a little house cleaning.
House cleaning here, folks. All right. Davis at 86 after 8. But Rico Baldinelli now working on a huge strike in the 8th. That's the box that Dan is always talking about.
This is the one.
The crucial 8th box. What he says, you put your opponents away.
Left with a full horseman on the right, and he's got the 7 and the 9 left. Wants a big fill out of this, though.
Okay, only 5 on the fair.
He wants at least 3 more. He's going to go after that trine down in the corner.
Not going to get it. So, folks, we're not done here yet. 107 after 9.
Yeah, Kevin's on other. He sees it, too.
He does see it.
If anything, that here, Rico wants to put a mark.
All right.
Took the 5-10 hanging there.
Important ball here, folks.
2 pieces of wood. He'll get to the slider. He looks like he'll take the second piece far out.
Gets him both. I saw the big sigh of relief. Kevin Davis looking on. Big sigh of relief from Rico Baldinelli. Big spare in the 10th. I mean, he must have been really concerned about that 5, putting up 5 on the fill for the strike. So we have a little more house cleaning going on. The ball coming our way. Rico will
clean
take care
himself.
Of that one, though.
He would like to at least to see a 7 or above fill on this one.
I know Kev's got to be thinking.
Well, that's the place to leave that.
Yeah.
Right there with an 8 fill.
All right, Baldinelli, 125. And here's Kevin Davis.
It's a 19-pin lead.
Looking for some huge marks to close it out.
Plus the 8, yeah. He needs a couple big strikes here.
That's a huge spare there, leaving just the 6 and 10, plenty of wood in front. In the 9th.
He needs a strike here.
Yeah, he really does. Baldinelli just finished with a 244, so he needs something big here.
Kick it.
Oh, just misses the strike. Unbelievable. He had a piece of wood flipping over towards it.
Yeah, we're right behind the 10 pin down there.
Davis was really counting on that 10 to go.
That was the, I think that was, he knew it too when he hit it. It was a good hit. It just flipped right behind the 10
pin. Yeah, it really was.
And they'll go now.
All right, folks. You're looking at your finals, 244 to 240. We were wondering who could do it. Rico Baldinelli got the job done. He finally, after 7 weeks, defeats Kevin Davis. 244 to 240. Unbelievable by performance by both bowlers. We'll be back to talk to both of them right after these messages. All right, welcome back, folks. Unbelievable performance by Rico Baldinelli. We were wondering who could take down Kevin Davis. Baldinelli did, 244 to 240. He did it by throwing 3 strikes and 4 spares for 1250 points. He's the one that strung them together because Kevin Davis also had 3 strikes and 4 spares, but for only 500 points. Unbelievable performance, Earl.
It was the, I think it was a couple fills there. And Rico ran a few marks together, as always, but 4 pins, you can count those anywhere. As an average bowler knows, it's the pinning that you do, but those are the breaks.
Absolutely. Now let's go over to Trina Fernandez, who's standing by with our former champion, Kevin Davis. Trina.
Yes, thanks, Phil. And week after week, Kevin Davis has been telling me, I don't want to talk to you, because he knows that means that you lost the match if you're talking to me. And I didn't think it was going to happen. I thought you were going to be over with Phil for a long time. tell us what happened with Rico and, you know, why you think you're standing over here, unfortunately, with me.
I didn't really pick up the single pins and stuff. I left a lot of pins standing that time. Rico was throwing a decent ball. You know, we didn't have high scores, but it was a good match. Went right down to the last box. Made it interesting.
Definitely kept it interesting. You guys had a great match, and I know that we'll see you again in the finals.
Yeah, hopefully I'll see Rico in the finals, and we can try this again.
Okay. All right, back to you, Phil.
Hey, thanks a lot, Trina. Standing by with us now is our new champ, Rico Baldinelli. Rico, unbelievable performance, but that spare and that strike in the eighth was unbelievable.
That was a good strike in the eighth. The fill wasn't so great, but I came back in the end.
Yeah, I mean, it was unbelievable. Great performance. Congratulations for taking this one. Folks, we have to get going, but before we go, for Dan Murphy, Earl Smith filling in, did an excellent job. Trina Fernandez, the entire crew, we want to say a special thanks to Wes Ray, who's been doing an excellent job all year. That's going to do it for us, folks. We'll see you next time on the American Car Care Center's $30,000 Candlepin Challenge.